Hello students, I hope my last video gave you some ideas about Mendel's law of inheritance. Now let us continue our discussion. Today I discuss on deviation from Mendelism. After Mendel, different workers work on inheritance or heredity. They find that in some cases Mendel laws are deviated. Here I give a one example of this deviation. Here a cross is done between two progeny or two individual plants of Mirabilis jalapa. One is red color flower producing plant and another one is white color flower producing plant. Here red color is dominant character. You know about the what is dominant and what is recessive. In F1 generation it produces a new a plant which produce pink color flower, but according to Mendel's law, it should be a red color flowering plant. In second generation, or that after crossing between the F1 generation, in F2 generation, we find a three types of plant. One is red color flower producing plant, two pink color flower producing plant, and one white color flower producing plant. So phenotypic ratio here is 1:2:1, but in Mendel's monohybrid cross, this ratio was 3:1. So this ratio is deviated. This condition or this phenomenon is known as incomplete dominance. So what is incomplete dominance? Individuals with contrasting features where produce some intermediate phenotype, the phenomenon is called incomplete dominance. Another deviation from Mendelism is codominance. What is codominance? Codominance is when both the alleles of a gene expressed themselves in the heterozygote. That is, during heterozygote condition, normally we found that the dominant character is expressed. But in case of codominance, the both the alleles are expressed equally. I give you one example of codominance. This codominance found in human blood group, AMN blood group. This blood group is discovered by Landsteiner and Levin in 1927. Here, the gene of AMN blood group have two alleles, M and N. When M allele present in homozygote position, the phenotype is M, and when N allele in homozygote position, then the phenotypic blood group is N. But when M and N present in a heterozygote position, they expressed both the character. The blood group is MN blood group. So, they divided human population into three groups. One is M, another one is MN, and next one is N blood group. M blood group containing gene produce anti response, control the M gene is responsible for the producing M antigen. N gene is responsible for the producing N antigen, and MN gene is MN allele ki it responsible for the producing M and N antigen, both antigen. Normally in human body, the serum does not contain any antibodies for MN antigen. You know that this antigen is present in RBC, surface of RBC. An antibody is present in plasma, but in human blood serum does not contain any antibody of the MN. That's why agglutination does not occur in human blood group, human blood. But in rabbit, if this MN blood is injected into a rabbit blood, then they produce the antibody anti-M for antigen M and anti-N for antigen N. So they coagulate the blood M phenotypic blood or MN phenotypic blood, but does not coagulate the N phenotypic blood. And if injected the N phenotypic blood into the rabbit blood, then they coagulate the MN type blood and N type blood. Next, another deviation occurs in case of multiple alleles. What is multiple alleles? Generally, we know that each gene has two alleles. If in those cases the presence of more than two alleles of a gene, then this is called the multiple alleles. These multiple alleles found start kuricho. These multiple alleles are found in human blood group ABO blood group. This blood group system is discovered by Carl Landsteiner in 1900. Here, I gene has three alleles, IA, IB and I0, or it is denoted as small I. And on the basis of this blood group, the human population is divided into four groups, A, B, AB and O. The A blood group containing human body's genotype is IA or IA I0, and they produce agglutinogen capital A. Where it is found? It is found on the surface of RBC, and in plasma they produce antibody B. Phenotype B, the genotype is IB or IBI0, and agglutinogen is B. Agglutinin is anti-A. And phenotype AB, in case of phenotype AB, the genotype is IA, IB and agglutinogen is A and B. So agglutinin is 0. Here no agglutinin is produced, that is antibody. Agglutinin is antibody. This is not produced in case of AB phenotype. And phenotype O, here genotype is I0 and I0. Here agglutinogen, that is antigen, is absent, and agglutinin is AB. That's why O blood group is called the universal donor, and AB blood group is called universal recipient. Because of this, O blood group's human does not contain any agglutinogen. ABO blood group also help in paternity detection. Now, ABO inheritance of ABO blood group. If I saw a cross between different blood groups animal, we saw that in case of dominant crossing, the phenotypic expected progeny's phenotypic ratio is 3:1. 3:1. In case of B, it also 3:1. But in case of codominant crossing, then the ratio is deviated. That is 1:2, 1:1, or 1:2, 2:1. Again, we also see in case of B and AB crossing, where the ratio is 1:2, 2:1. So, in case of pure dominant cross, there we find the 3:1 ratio. But in case of codominance, then the ratio is 1:2, 2:1. So, ABO is multiple allelic gene. ABO is multiple allelic gene. Another multiple allelic gene is Rh factor. It was discovered by Landsteiner and Weiner in 1940. At first, it was thought that the Rh factor have two alleles, R, capital R, and small r. But after that, it is discovered that the Rh factor have 8 alleles, R, R prime, R prime double prime, R y, capital R 0, capital R 1, capital R 2, and capital R z. Rh factor is two type, Rh positive and Rh negative. Rh positive gene produce antigen D. Rh negative does not contain any antigen. Next topic is erythroblastosis fetalis. It is a abnormal disease occur when a cross when father is Rh positive and mother, if the father is Rh positive and mother is Rh negative. Their first child, if Rh positive, then is no problem, but in mother body produce Rh antigen antibody for antigen D produce antibody D. But after second child, the child will be die due to hemolytic jaundice and anemia, because these antibody coagulate the blood of the child, second child, who is Rh positive. Next, pleiotropy. What is pleiotropy? Pleiotropy is when a single gene has more than one phenotypic effect. One gene is responsible for more than one phenotypic character. Example of pleiotropy is, one example of pleiotropy is Drosophila. The gene of Drosophila for white eye, the gene which is responsible for white eye for Drosophila, it also responsible for the shape of sperm storage organ of female body and other structure of female body. Another pleiotropic example is phenylketonuria controlling phenylketonuria controlling gene. And another one example is Syns gene of Drosophila, and sickle cell anemia also the example of pleiotropy. Sickle cell anemia is a one type of abnormality in hemoglobin. Here the gene which is control this anemia hemoglobin is capital S gene. It is a recessive gene. When it is present in homozygous condition, it produces sickle cell anemia. What happened in sickle cell anemia? In case of sickle cell anemia, the hemoglobin is when the gene of sickle cell anemia is present in homozygous condition, then the hemoglobin quickly leave the oxygen and they form a fiber-like structure. That's why the structure of the red blood corpuscles, normal structure, this is the normal structure of red blood corpuscle. It is biconvex structure, is form a sickle cell like structure, and it is easily breakable and clog the narrow vessels, blood vessels. That's why the with anemia and also some breathing problem is occur in case of sickle cell anemia. But in the patient of sickle cell anemia could not affected by the malaria, because the protozoa of the malaria does not develop in this type of hemoglobin, in this type of RBC. They cannot survive in this RBC. This is called sickle cell anemia. Next, polygenic inheritance. What is polygenic inheritance? Here, a phenotypic expression controlled by many genes. The inheritance is called polygenic inheritance. That is a phenotypic character. One character is controlled by many genes. What is the opposite of the pleiotropic? Here, a single gene controls one phenotypic character. Where polygenic inheritance, one phenotypic character is controlled by many genes. And the genes are, so these genes are called polygenes. Here some environmental condition also affect this formation of polygenic condition, like height of the human. It is here no such distinct deviation between tall and short. Color of the human skin, color of the eye, etc. is the example of polygenic inheritance.